Hello there, this is DBT, and these are the Vrooms. And alright, let's continue playing some more Asphalt 8, and today I'm gonna be testing out this thing in multiplayer, the Arash AF8, not to be confused with the Arash AF10, which is the one that I made some videos on, was it last week, was it this week, I don't know. Now, this is the one in Class A, at the rank of 1772, and I'm really curious to test it out in multiplayer, because, well, I really never played much with this car, and I'll explain why in a second. But you know how this rolls, I'm gonna go into Classic C. I'm gonna show you how many races I have, being 46 so far. So you will see every single race that I do, no cherry picking, whether I win, lose, or whatever happens, that gets recorded. So without further ado, let's start this up. Now, given the rank of the car at 1772, in theory, it should be about as performant, in theory, as the Camaro IE, or maybe the Porsche 911 GT3 RS Europe Derived Edition, what a name that is. But honestly, you know how this is, ranks don't always tell you the truth, and whether or not this performs to that level, it is unknown. I see a 911 GT3 RS right behind me, and you can see that it out-accelerated me, which is indeed what you would expect, but let's see, I'm keeping the first place. Now, this is a peculiar car for me, because I think this is, well, I have a lot of cars, festival cars, you remember, festivals were before, oh god! Festivals before they were named car hunts, but there were a lot of cars that were free, and that's how I have a lot of cars, which I eventually over time have been upgrading. However, this is one of those cars that it's newer in the game, and it was premium only from the moment that it came out. I don't remember, it probably was still about $10 or something like that, but yeah, it was a premium car, and actually I wasn't super interested in getting it when it came out, because I didn't think it was a very interesting looking car. But, you know, over time I was like, nah, I'll get it. I think it was the second time that I was made available, which was not too long ago. I went for the car hunt. I don't remember if it actually got me another car or what, but at least I wanted this one, because by that time I already knew what this sounded like, and man, just listen to this thing. It rooms so good. It's the same engine sound that the 4GT uses, which I've said that it's one of my favorite engine sounds in the entire game, so there is that. All right, second place, not too bad in spite of some mess-ups here and there. I got defeated by a 177, but I did beat a ZR1, 177, ZR1, Grand Sport Vitesse, and a Year of the Rabbit Edition. Well, I'm surprised that one is in last place, but you know what? I'll take it! So yeah, as far as I know, this car is one that you cannot get in a free-to-play fashion, because, well, both times that I know that has been out there has been paid only, and then you cannot get it even through Master Keys. First, because they haven't updated the Master Keys in forever. But second, because this is a car of the rank 1772, and in theory, the 1772 should not be in the Master Keys. Though I do remember that some Master Keys in some class did have some end of bracket, meaning the highest ranked car, in the key, which is not supposed to happen, but oh well, I don't know if that got fixed or what. Either way, in theory, you should not be able to get this car in a free-to-play fashion, so yeah, I don't know what to make. I don't know what to make with that information, but there we go. So yeah, I actually know this car from Asphalt 9. That's where I saw it first. It's a Class B in that car, and it's a very meh Class B. But, you know, then we have it over here. It's Class A. In theory, it's a high-ranked Class A, so it should be a good car. And so far, let me tell you that from what I'm driving it right now, it's not an uncomfortable car. The nitro is very, very good. At least a triple tap doesn't feel like it's drinking it away, so that seems fine. And acceleration, well, you saw that the 911 GT3 RS did out-accelerate me, but then again, that thing out-accelerates just about anything, so how is that a surprise? But yeah, overall, this seems pretty pleasant. I'm surprised about it. And got defeated again by the 177, but I did beat two ZR1s and two Agera Rs. All right, pretty cool. Let me swap the color of this thing real quick. All right, there we go. So still, you can see the counter, but I really wanted to have a look at the colors, because the default color for this car is one that I don't love, though it's interesting. It is very strange orangey with some slightly purpley secondary tone. Do you see it in the reflections? It's kind of weird. I don't know. It's like some strange burnt orange. I don't hate it, but I don't love it either. Then we got it on white. We got it on yellow, which is the one that I was driving. Some dark green. Got it on gray, which, by the way, it's just gray. It doesn't really look silver. It's more like a matte. No, it's not matte. It is reflective. It just doesn't look super nice or anything, but whatever. We got it on blue, red, and straight up black. So in general, you know what? I'm gonna drive it in the official color just because might as well, right? But I still, I don't love it. Oh boy, I was getting scared there for a second because this took forever to load to find a lobby, but here we go, and it's actually more than four players, so that's kind of nice. But yeah, overall, so far the car seems pretty alright. I'm not gonna say that it feels like the most amazing car out there, but it's not terrible. And like I said, the rooms on these cars are absolutely great, so that's already enough for me to want to drive it. You know that? You know how I am. If I like the car visual, that's enough for me to drive it. If I like the way that it sounds and the visuals aren't just straight up insulting, then I'd like to drive it too. And even then, I might still drive some cars that I don't necessarily love, so long as they're interesting enough to play with. But so far, this car is actually showing to be pretty decent. Nothing stands out to me like, oh, this is a very bad side of this car. The drifting isn't exactly super sharp, but it is not bad by any means. And by the way, I took that one a little bit wide because I'm running low on nitro, and that guy touches me without nitro, that means knockdown. So, all right. Fine, mister. You took my first place, whatever. Now well played. But yeah, all right. So got beaten by a 911 GT3, whoa. But there's another two over here. This is a rare car, and I'm surprised to be finding so many in this video. That's kind of cool. Well, I mean, so many. How many has been? But still, kind of cool to see. Because you would see many more times a Camaro IE than a 911 GT3 Low Edition. Okay, fortunately, this one didn't take as long to start. But yeah, interesting car. And with this, I complete the Arash collection. All of the two cars in the Arash collection. Yay! Not that that means anything. Back in the day, the game used to have collections. It was a feature where if you had a certain set of cars, I think the game would give you some rewards, like a decal or something. Those were, man, I missed some of those things. I understand why Game Love wanted to get rid of those type of features, because they were, I'm fine. They were probably somewhat difficult to maintain, especially with how many cars kept on being added in the game. And then you had a collection that was called, I don't know, I'm making this up, but just to give you an example. If you have a collection that is called Italian Hypercars, and you completed it because in 2015 it had this many cars, well, by now there's probably another 25 cars added to that collection. So what is that? Should they make a second collection? Should they make it so that the collection that already existed now is edited and you need to complete, you know? So I can see why they wanted to get rid of some of those systems, though I still weep. I mean, I might be exaggerating with the weep, but I'm still sad that we no longer have Mastery. Because even not, I know that at some point, people were able to farm Mastery in order to get credits and whatnot. I'm not thinking about that when I say that I miss Mastery, but I just like Mastery because it had some additional game modes, like the Rush Hour, I think it was called, where there was more traffic. There was one without Nitro, which was called Unplug. And it was just interesting to drive the same car. It was, I don't know, I liked it. And sadly, all of that is gone. But right, I keep on getting beat by the 911 GT3 RS Year of Rabbit Edition, but I did beat a 177 and an Evija. Evija, I learned that that's how you're supposed to pronounce that. All right, here we go. China, this should be a good test for the handling of this car in general. Now, handling, it's a bit difficult for me to try to say, oh, it's good or bad handling. Obviously, if it handles amazing, it's easy to tell. And if it handles like a rock, then it's easy to tell. But anything in the middle, then it becomes really blurry to me. But okay, right away, I can tell you this handles good. So let me summarize. Good handling, pretty decent drift, pretty good nitro duration, and pretty alright acceleration. I think this is one of those that are jack of all trades. Maybe it's not a master of anything in particular, but in general it does seem to be a very, very balanced car, and honestly, I think that's good. Not every car needs to be a king on everything. In fact, a car that is a king on everything, that's a straight up broken car. Audi R8 what's it called? Audi R8 Special Edition back in the day. But anyway, no, this seems balanced, and oh, let's go, baby, I'm gonna take first place unless I mess it up, so let's not mess it up. And yeah, I think this is one of those very, very well-balanced cars. I mean, I think this one does deserve the 1772 rank, because overall the performance is very good, but without being OP in any particular sense, at least that I can tell. Now, if someone wants to say that, oh, probably because of the speed recovery, no, I don't know, I don't do that measurements, but look at that. Beating an Evija 4GT Mark II and a Dodge Dart X Edition, which, by the way, it's also this rank, but doesn't perform anywhere at this one, so like this car. So yeah, that's what I was saying, where the ranks actually just kind of lie, to be honest. And I think that's in general consistent as to why I don't do proper car reviews in this game, or pretty much in any game, because unless I have hard numbers that don't lie, it's kinda oh Jesus Christ, I forgot to do the trip. Well done, DBT. Unless it's absolutely straight up OP or it's a straight up garbo, anything in between those 2 points, it just kinda meshes into this weird unrecognizable blob of information for me. Like, yeah, I don't know, it seems okay. That's all I can tell you. So yes, you know, I always say that don't come to this channel looking for proper car reviews in here for the performance in this game, because I will oh my god, I wasn't trying to knock you down, buddy. I was just trying to mind my own business. Oh, I'm so sorry. And it was a 4GT Mark II. Man, that makes me sad. And by the way, if you noticed, I changed the color of the car to white while I was waiting, because why not? But oh, let's go, baby. Am I gonna get another W? Yeah, baby. All right. Pretty good car. And to be fair, I did drive it a little bit at Pro before I made my decision to get it on the Car Hunt Cup. Man, I keep saying that's a great thing that Gameloft has done. But all right, I beat an Agera S in the Penn's edition. Oh, I'm so sorry, man. I didn't mean to knock you down. I'm sad to see that you went from first or second to last, which is just fourth, but still, last. Okay, this one also took a very long time, so I'm a bit worried for the lifespan of my boosters, but oh well. Man, I'm telling you, oh, that's a the tomato. And the Pagan is on the R. Oh man, they brought the peculiar cars, huh? Alright, that's fine, that's fine. So, yeah, it's just kind of sad for me. I mentioned it before, I don't know which other video, probably I was doing also a test of Class A. But it's just kind of sad because this bracket used to be so... Whoa, he's pushing me. This bracket used to be so busy. There was always players to play with. And unfortunately, nowadays, that doesn't seem to be the case anymore. Now, that's not... Oh, Jesus, what happened there? That's not to say that there's nobody to play with. You can clearly see that there's still people to play with, but it's taking a while for this to load. And to be fair, it could also just be the time at which I am recording this, but I remember back in the day, it didn't matter what time I would play. At all times, I would find players all around, but I guess this is just the sad, what would I say? The sad destiny of any game that eventually is going to lose the player base and we're going to be left alone. It's fine. Alright, third place, this one didn't go fantastic, but you know, results are results, and that's what I'm saying, that I don't do the cherry picking, so not a fantastic show for the car, but it's okay, at least you get to see what I can do with it, which is not a lot, but you know, it's there. I did beat the Zonda R and the ZR1, so I guess that's something. Ooh, orbital loop. Now this could be promising, because you know, sometimes I get some decent luck over here, so let's see if by any chance I can make something good happen over here. Though I do have some more. Ooh, look at that! You don't see those every day, but okay, let's see. Let's see what we can do. Come on. Alright, acceleration. I can tell you it's better than the ZR1, though then I bounce on the wall and mess it up, but whatever. Alright, here we go. Here we go. What is that in front of me? Is that the Porsche? No. What is that? Oh, it's a Diablo! Hey, Mr. Person driving the Diablo, I respect you for driving such a beauty. You know what? If I lose to someone, I wouldn't mind losing to a Diablo. Just saying. Oh, God! Oh, I thought I was gonna ring out. Holy moly, first place! Let's go, baby! Now let's not mess it up, DBT. Focus, you can keep this. So, overall, I'm gonna say I'm really surprised of the performance of this car. Like I said, I drove it during the Car Hunt Cup, which is a great thing that Gameloft added the Car Hunt Cups, because you get to try the car at pro rank. You don't need to own it, so but you can test it. And with that, I play with it, and I'm like, you know what, it sounds fantastic, it looks okay, and it performs apparently very alright, so that's what convinced me to get it. And besides, it has a very large wing, maybe not positioned very tall on the car, but it's still a very large wing, so I like it. And yeah, overall the performance, it's not disappointing at all. Again, like I said, it's not that it's necessarily gonna be a king or anything like that, but it absolutely is a very competitive car, and I would say it's on the top end of the Class A cars. I could be wrong about this, but hey, I could be wrong about a lot of things, and yet, here I am making videos. If you enjoyed this video, you know what to do. Hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, because we're trying to get to the 10,000 subscribers, and if you want to get a hard on a pin, you need to leave me the key phrase, which for today is going to be, where is the Arash AF9? That's all for now. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care, and stay safe. Bye-bye.